looking at what we've seen from the Hornets, what do you think?
Well, they use the fast break to generate some easy buckets before the defense could get set.
Yeah, they did a great job. Just the initial thrust of that attack as soon as they got the ball, constantly in transition.
Ntilikina. And he recovers it. Goes back up. He gets a chance now to catch up with the fourth member of our crew, Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Kevin, before he became a head coach in Memphis and New York, David Fizdale spent 8 seasons as an assistant under Eric Spoelstra in Miami. Now, Spo said, he's a brilliant basketball mind that has exceptional gold standard level communication skills. One of the most talented coaches I've ever had. So Kevin Fizdale is highly respected.
David, he sure is. Great reputation. Now getting a shot. Thank you so much.
That kind of activity from Kevin Knox. Is going to pose some problems for the defense.
That one misses. Hornets leading by 3. Here's Batum. Lead pass was put in just the right spot. Batum's got his second bucket tonight.
Just can make it so much easier for your teammate when you throw that lead pass that gets to him right on the money, whether that's on the run or in the shooting pocket.
And Gibson sends it back.
Taj Gibson doing a good job of just getting the hands up, and then the instincts come into play with the block.
Just fine to shoot. Drops in the layup for 2. Gibson's got his first basket of the night.
Pretty sweet pass there as Knox showing his ability to read the floor.
That's a 2 from Rozier. Quick shot there and it's off target. And one of those little spark plug guys, Terry Rozier. Enters the game with a break, I think a chip on his shoulder.
I mean, the story goes, as a kid, when his temper flared, his mother would have to sit on him until he cooled down. He's learned to channel that fire and emotion into his game.
And the Hornets miss again. New York trails by 3. Inside. It's blocked.
And the impact Bridges makes on the defensive end, showing he's not to be messed with.
Here's Smith. Pass to Knox. He shoot again. No luck, they battled on the glass, but couldn't knock it down. Fires for 3. Nailed from 3-point land. Knox has got it all tied up now for the Knicks.
I think the defense has more concerns out there on the floor. And they give him a good open look from the perimeter.
And the Hornets call time here. Brent, at this point, perennial contenders sometimes coast to the final games of the regular season. Any danger that they can't hit that right button or flip the switch and get back into gear?
When you hear analysts say that the playoffs are all about matchups, they are exactly right. I mean, you and I talked about this, Kevin, several years ago about
the time
going into the playoffs. Teams don't have to be hot. You don't have to be 10-2 in the last 12 games for your playoffs, because all of a sudden, if you're matched up against a team that's owned you all year long, your chances of winning that series are very, very slim. So it becomes just, let's get in and let's find out who we're playing, and then we'll get to work.
Biombo with the block. Fast break now for Charlotte. Seller with it. Now defended by Randle. Bridges misses. Payton, right side. Buries it down low. And the Knicks lead by 2.
Well, they're trying to take command of this game, but it's been competitive so far.
Yeah, everybody trying to get away from one another, and the threads are keeping them close. This has been highly competitive. Randle getting up there, explosive vertically on that play with great timing.
Zeller.